Hey there guys, welcome back for another presentation in your World Regional Geography course. This time we're going to introduce the realm of Northern Africa and Southwest Asia. Well, let's introduce the realm. So this realm shares three key dominant traits that influence all human activity. First is climate, second is Islam, and the third is natural resources. So going back to climate, the most prominent climate type is B, although there are variations of C and H. Islam, well, most people in the realm are Muslim, which is more than just a religion. It serves as a strong cultural force that has historically either unified or divided its people. The natural resources, well, many areas are incredibly rich with resources, with things such as oil, natural gas, minerals, etc. But it's not equal. Some places have a lot, and some places just don't have any. And another resource that we can think about is the limitation of fresh, drinkable water. So the phrase cultural hearths. So although it is believed that Jericho may be one of the earliest and first cities, the two cultural hearths of this realm are Mesopotamia and the Nile Valley. So as we can observe in the diagram on the right, I've provided the regions of North Africa, Southwest Asia, and Turkestan. But down here we can see the Fertile Crescent, and we observe that Mesopotamia is really in the central point of that Fertile Crescent. Now, human civilization also emerged along the Nile, as when the river floods, rich nutrients are deposited to fuel agriculture. Access to fresh water has been an issue for centuries. In fact, many ruins of extensive aqueducts from Greek and Roman times are found throughout the realm. There are waters that are stored underground in this region in what's considered the Nubian aquifer, but it's not rechargeable or sustainable. And I mentioned the comment of the potato, which I'll get to in a moment. So the diagram on the right is showing the Nile River and the ancient civilizations that are right along it, and some are a little farther away. Well, what we have found historically is that there's been times of great flooding and then when water was more scarce. So when you have additional water resources and the Nile was able to spread out and fuel the oases that were around it, civilizations were able to spread out. But during times of severe drought when water, fresh water, was limited, people then moved back along the Nile. I mention the potato because one of the largest crops that's produced in this area is actually the potato. It's being brought in, they use additional pumped fresh water, and it's actually quite easy to mine because the potato itself, when you're harvesting, it's in sand, so it just comes right up, and they pack it in peat moss that is being imported from Ireland. The diagram on the left is an original Roman aquifer, which is pretty interesting, you know, because aquifers is just really an aqueduct, is on the surface that transports water long distances. When here in California, we have a couple aqueducts themselves. We have the California and the Los Angeles, as well as part of the Colorado River aqueduct that we can actually move water back and forth on. The aquifer that I mentioned, the Nubian aquifer, which is underlaying the surface, is a confined aquifer, meaning that it's trapped, and that water is from probably the last glaciation that occurred in this area, which is over 1,000 years ago. So that water is really old, and there's not enough sustainability of water resources to replenish it. So although it's almost a limitless amount of water at this point, it's first come, first serve, and if renewable resources and water is not being regulated, such as with perhaps a desalinization plant where you take salt water to make it fresh, these regions will run out of fresh water. Looking at the population density map and the raised relief, again we see a majority of our population is along the perimeter, except for in Egypt, where a majority of your population is along the Nile River, along that fresh resource. Then, moving to the right-hand side, we can look at the raised relief, we certainly see that there are correlations with where populations live and where they don't live. We see that in most of your desert areas, there's no one living there unless they're along or near water resources. Other than that, we're looking at most of the either the highlands of areas, as we can see in this region right down here, or they're going to be along the coast. So looking at Muhammad and Islam. So Islam has its origins with Muhammad, who was born 571 years after the birth of Jesus, when Christianity was already well established. Muhammad received his revelations through the angel Gabriel and passed them to his followers, who wrote down his words into what became the Quran. After the death of Muhammad, Islam divided into a number of different factions. The two most prevalent divisions are Islam, are going to be of Sunni, and Shia. Religious states are structured around the laws based on religious regulations that are usually determined by religious leaders. Secular states are structured around civil law, which is decided on the democratic consensus. And I provided a very brief and short story of religion so we can see where Muhammad lies, Jesus Christ, and also the Torah. And how, as you can see, we can actually take it back up the top and seeing that it starts from Abraham, which was then Adam and Eve, and then the Creator. Which is quite interesting when you think about just religion as a whole, as to that metaphorically, they have the same stories and same people and it has the same origin, yet it can be taught and treated so very differently from one another. So looking at North Africa and the African transition zone, the three main physical features of North Africa are the Atlas Mountains, the Sahara Desert, as well as the Nile. Most of North Africa's population lives along the Mediterranean coast, or along the Nile, as stated earlier when looking at the dot density population map. The African transition zone creates the southern boundary for North Africa. The zone serves also as a transition between the arid type B climates as well as the tropical type A climates. It is also the transition between the dominance of Islam and the dominance of Christianity and animism. The African transition zone cuts through the center of Sudan and divides the country along religious and ethnic distinctions. Moving forward, looking at Arabs, Islam, and oil, the Arabian Peninsula is a desert region. The mountains along the western and southern edges receive most of their rainfall, although there are no rivers or major lakes on the peninsula. Water and resources that are vital to human activity is incredibly scarce throughout this region. The export of oil and natural gas is what drives the economies as well in this realm, and agriculture activity is dependent on the availability of water by rainfall, underground aquifers, oases, and others such as desalinization of seawater. To put it in perspective, most summer days can exceed 120 degrees Fahrenheit. Lastly, in the Gulf states, the smaller countries in the land area are more open to promoting women's rights and responsibilities in the public-private sector. Now moving into Iraq, Turkey, and Iran. Iraq was ruled by Saddam Hussein from 1979 to 2003. Iraq invaded Kuwait in 1990, which prompted the first Persian Gulf War. Hussein's use of weapons of mass destruction provoked a U.S. invasion in 2003, which eventually removed Hussein from power. Iran is a religious state that has often been at war or clashed with its Middle Eastern neighbors. Reformers and many young people in Iran would like to see the country become more democratic and more open to personal freedoms. Turkey has a relatively stable, democratically elected government. Turkey's physical geography provides for large supplies of food crops as well as hydroelectric energy. The map on the right shows the two ethnic divisions of Arab and Kurd, also looking at the religion divisions as well. Now looking at Central Asia, known as Turkestan, as well as Afghanistan. Central Asia is a landlocked region that receives very little rainfall. The two large desert regions are located at the region's core. Vast grasslands dominate the northern sector. This realm has been dominated by the Soviet Union during the 20th century. The transition to independence has challenged the region to adjust to change in political and in economical systems. Afghanistan is one of the poorest countries in the world based on data on standard living. However, the country has one of the largest deposits of valuable minerals and ores in the world, just waiting to be extracted. Well, the following is a summary of trends in Central Asia. So, shift from Soviet Union to independent states, a rise in authoritarian governments and then corruption, increase of cultural influence of Islamic institutions, global economic focus on extractive activities, increase in military activity over control of resources, a decline in agriculture as an economic base, and continued concern for environmental problems. The diagram on the right shows the elevation of these areas. So as you can see, focus in the middle is the central highlands. We can see that they, you know, cap around 10,000 feet. Otherwise, most areas are at sea level. A few are actually below. So that was your intro to the realm. So very quickly, let's talk about the testing, some questions. So who was at the center of the Fertile Crescent of Mesopotamia? What is the boundary where the dry, arid conditions of Sahara Desert meet the tropical conditions of equatorial Africa? The next question, which of the following is not included in the realm of North Africa and Southwest Asia? And then last will be the three main monotheistic religions of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam had emerged from the Middle East and can be traced back to which common patriarch? So again, these questions are found throughout the text, throughout the video, throughout the images in there. Don't forget to like the video, comment if you have other questions or comments, and don't forget to subscribe. So let's look at the answers. So who's at the center of the Fertile Crescent? It's going to be Iraq. What is the boundary where the dry, arid conditions of the Sahara Desert meet the tropical conditions of equatorial Africa? It's the African Transition Zone. So which of the following is not included in the realm? So that would be Namibia. It's kind of a multiple choice question. You'll see it later on your exams. And the three main monotheistic religions, they all trace back to Abraham. Again, I hope this was helpful. If you have any other questions, let me know. Otherwise, we'll talk soon.